Hi guys, I'm Shyam from websitelearners.com. Today we're going to see how you can take a backup of your website. Okay, so first let's see what is a backup. Backup simply means saving a copy of your website on a particular date and then keeping it safe. Now after you take a backup, let's say you keep making changes to your site and one day your site suddenly stops working. What do you do in this situation? How do you recover your site? If you have a backup, you just have to restore that backup and your site will be working again. Now, after you restore the backup, your site will look exactly as it was when taking the backup. So we highly recommend that you always take a backup of your site so that you never lose your work. Okay guys, so this is how backup works. Okay, so let's get started. First, let's see how our site looks like. Okay, so this is the site which I've built on WordPress. Now, if you want to backup this site, you need to do three things. The first thing is to install the backup plugin on your site. So to install the plugin, let's go to our dashboard and then go to plugins and click add new. Now search for a plugin called Updraft. And you'll get this plugin. Now this is the plugin which we're going to use for backup. So to install the plugin, let's click install and activate. And you can see here that the plugin has been installed. So once the plugin is installed, we can now take the backup. So to take a backup, click settings and then click backup now. Now make sure all of these are selected and click backup. That's it. We have now taken a backup. Now if we go to this tab here, you can see the backup which we just took. So this is how you can take a backup of your website. Now how do you use this backup? Okay, so there are two situations where you might need to use your backup. Let's take the first situation. Let's say by mistake you changed something on your site and you want to go back. You can use your backup to go back to a previous time. So let's try it out. I'm going to go into pages and let's say I delete the home page. Now if I go to the site and click refresh, you can see that our homepage is gone. Now, if you want to restore the homepage, all you have to do is go to Updraft, click Restore, and select the backup which you want to restore. Now, choose all the options here and click Restore to restore your site. Now, if we go to our site and click refresh, you can see that we have got our homepage again. So this is how you can use the backup to restore your site. So now you cannot always remember to take a backup every time. So let's say you take a backup today and after 2 weeks of working on your site, your website crashes. You will lose all of the changes which was made during those 2 weeks. So to avoid this, we can set up a schedule which will take a backup of our site at regular intervals. By doing this, our site's content will always be backed up without having to backup manually. So let's go to part 2 of this tutorial where we see how to set up an automatic backup. So to set up automatic backup, let's click settings under Updraft. And then let's go to the settings tab. So here we need to choose how often you want to take the backup. So I recommend you choose weekly in both of these places and then set this option to 4 and 4. Now this setting will take one backup every week and it'll keep that backup for 4 weeks. So this means you will always have the backup for the last 4 weeks. Okay? So next we need to choose where we want to store our backups. So Updraft gives you different places where you can store your backup. I'm going to choose Google Drive as my storage. And then scroll down and click Save. Now, as soon as you click Save, Updraft will ask you to link your Google account so that it can store the backups there. So to link it, let's click here. And it'll ask you to sign into your Google account. So we'll click here. Now Google will ask for your confirmation. So let's click Allow. And it will take you to this page. So now let's click Complete to finish the linking. And now Google Drive account will be linked to Updraft. So this means all your backups will be safely saved to your Google Drive. So the automatic backup setup is now complete. And you can see that the first backup will be taken on this date. So if we go to this page here, over time you'll get more and more backups, which are the backups for the last 4 weeks. So now our site will be backed up automatically and it's safe from crashes. Now after we have these backups, what if our site crashes like this? And when we try to reach the admin area, what if we are not able to access it? So next, let's see how we can use our backups to recover a crashed site. So in order to recover a crashed site, we need to do 3 things. First, we need to remove the old WordPress installation, which has now crashed. And then in step 2, we need to make a fresh WordPress installation on the same domain. And then finally, we can restore the website using the files we have in our Google Drive. So to recover our crashed site, we are first going to remove the current WordPress installation. Okay, so to remove it, let's go to our web host. So I have my hosting with GoDaddy, so I'm just going to go there. And then click sign in. Now in order to remove WordPress, I'm going to click manage all. And then click these 3 dots. And click remove. Now GoDaddy will ask you to confirm. So I'm going to type reset. And click remove. And the crashed WordPress site will be removed. Now once the old site has been removed, we can now restore our site. So let's go to step 2 of recovering a crashed website, which is to reinstall WordPress on the same domain. So to install a fresh WordPress site, let's click Add Site. And let's quickly go through the setup process which will install WordPress. So we'll click Get Started. And then choose your domain. Click Next. And then again Next. Now keep a username and password for the new WordPress site. And click install. Okay, so now a new WordPress site will be installed on your domain. So once it's done, we can click get started. And then skip this by clicking no thanks. And okay. So you can see that we are now back on our WordPress dashboard. And WordPress is now working on quicktechie.com. Before we were not able to access the site, but now we have a working WordPress dashboard. Now before we restore our files from the backup, let's see how the site looks now. So to see the site, let's go here and click visit site. And you can see that we have the default WordPress site. So now it's time to restore our files from the backup. So to restore the files, we need to install the Updraft plugin on this new WordPress site. So to install Updraft, let's go to our dashboard. And then go to plugins and click Add New. Now search for Updraft again. And click Install. And activate. Okay, so now the plugin has been installed on our new website. Now, to restore our site, let's go to Settings. And now if we go to Existing Backups, you can see that there are no backups here. Now, how can we fix this? Because we installed Updraft on a new WordPress site, it is no longer linked to our Google account. So to help the plugin find the backups, we need to link it to the same Google Drive account which we used before. So to link the Google Drive account, let's go to Settings and then choose Google Drive and then scroll down and click Save. Now when you click Save, like we saw before, the plugin will ask you to link your Google Drive account. So let's click this link and choose your Google account and click Allow. Now to complete the linking, let's click here. And Google Drive is now successfully linked to the plugin. Now let's check the backups. So let's go to Existing Backups. And now if we click Rescan Remote Storage, you can see that we have got the backup which was stored in our Google Drive. Now to restore our site, all we have to do is click Restore, select all the items here and click Restore. That's it. Our website should now be restored. So to check it, let's go to our site which is here. And you can see that this was the default site which was there before. Now if we click Refresh, you can see that our site is restored with the same content. Okay, so everything is done. So that's it guys. This is how you can take a backup of your site and then restore it when you need it. Now, you know in WordPress, you get frequent updates for your plugins and themes. And there is always a chance of breaking your site when applying an update. Now, if you want Updraft to automatically take a backup before updating any plugin or theme, you can get the premium auto backup feature by clicking this link. So I hope this video helped. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.